The Philippine Labor Department clarifies the deployment of Filipino workers to Saudi Arabia is still suspended. Dole reiterated the policy after Migrant Workers Secretary Abdullah Mamao issued a department order on Monday lifting the deployment ban. Mamao said prior consultations were done with the Foreign Affairs and Labor Departments. But Labor Chief Silvestre Bello III says the decision is not up to Mamao.
Hindi tama yung ginawa at wala sa kapangyarihan ni Secretary Mamao na i-lift yung suspension na idineklara ng POEA Board. Tuloy pa rin yung suspension. No, until and unless na natupad na nila yung kanilang pangako na bayaran at isettle yung more than 5.1 billion claims ng ating 11,000 overseas Filipino workers.
Migrant groups slammed the government agencies for their confusing pronouncements.
Ang refleksyon niyan at pakiramdam ng mga OFWs niyan, paano kami habang kayo ay nagkakagulo? Paano yung serbisyo namin?
Alam niyo ba na yung mga gustong pumunta doon, inaaway na ako, sabi ko. Pero sabi ko, okay lang sa akin, awayin ako kasi baka what happened to them could happen to these people. Na pupunta sila doon, hindi na naman babayaran.
The Philippines stopped sending new domestic workers to Saudi Arabia last November in light of new complaints of employer abuse. Philippine economic managers make their pitch to Singaporean businessmen to invest in the country. During the virtual third Philippines-Singapore Business and Investment Summit, top officials presented the Philippines as an attractive investment destination amid the pandemic due to the new pro-business laws in the country. Among these laws are the Ease of Doing Business and Efficient Government Service Delivery Act and the Corporate Income Tax and Incentives Reform Act. Amendments to the Retail Trade Liberalization Act, Foreign Investments Act, and Public Service Act also highlighted as new measures that will promote the Philippines as an investment haven.
Over the last 5.5 years, President Duterte signed into law and implemented game-changing reforms to boost the Philippines' growth and competitiveness. Even as the world has been hit hard by the pandemic, our hard-won reforms bolstered our country's ability to recover and rebuild. Now is the best time for Singaporean investors to further expand their businesses in the Philippines. Our economy is recovering rapidly.
Singapore is the sixth largest trading partner of the Philippines and the third biggest source of remittances from overseas Filipino workers. Grab Philippines appeals to regulators to add more drivers to the ride-sharing service as easing pandemic curbs push up demand. Grab says a lot of their drivers had dropped out of the platform after their services were suspended at the height of lockdowns back in 2020. It adds, even if Grab wants to accept new driver partners, only those vehicles licensed by the Land Transport Franchising and Regulatory Board are allowed to be on the platform. The LTFRB recently opened nearly 8,000 slots for transport network vehicle services, but Grab says the slots are still not enough to meet increasing demand. Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation Chairperson Andrea Domingo supports having an independent regulating agency for online cockfighting or e-sabong. Domingo says such a move would free PAGCOR of some responsibilities, allowing the agency to focus on other gaming operations. Based on recent data from PAGCOR, 8-10% of the regulator's income comes from e-sabong. The industry has also generated about 1 billion pesos in revenue from January to April this year. But online cockfighting is also plagued with controversies, including alleged abductions. In other news, Philippine authorities order Columbia Pictures Industries to cease and desist from exhibiting Sony movie Uncharted until they're able to remove a scene containing an image of the nine-dash-line maritime claim of China. The Department of Foreign Affairs earlier flagged the movie for its scene that shows China's illegal claim. The agency says China's claim has already been settled in the 2016 arbitral award, adding that China never had historic rights in the waters within the so-called nine-dash line. This is not the first time that this has happened, as the DFA had prohibited the screening of DreamWorks animated feature Abominable back in 2019 for also featuring China's claim. Defense Chief Delfin Lorenzana says any decision regarding oil exploration activities in the West Philippine Sea will be up to the next administration. The Energy Department recently put on hold all exploration activities in the area until the Cabinet Security, Justice and Peace Coordinating Center issues the necessary clearance to proceed. This development came over a month after President Duterte said commitments must be honored in the joint exploration in Rectobank with China to avoid any possible conflicts. Rectobank is said to be rich in oil and natural gas.
We discussed it SGPCC, and we think that we will be facing some problems there, objection ng Chinese, because this is a unilateral. Tayo lang ito, hindi sila kasama. And there was this agreement that was signed between the Philippines and China before na joint exploration. Now it is unilateral. So, kun lang, iniwasan natin yung magiging sigalot yan sa West Philippine Sea.
In October 2020, the DOE issued a resume to work notice to the service contractors doing oil exploration in the areas of service contracts in the West Philippine Sea after being approved by Duterte.